All right, welcome to another episode of Mechanics and Duty. Today we have a 2012 Honda Accord 6-cylinder. We want to show you guys how to do the front brakes on this car. First thing that you want to remove is this Phillips head screw that's here to hold the rotor. You can use a screwdriver to get it out of there. Sometimes with these screws, they don't want to come out. What I do, I take a punch and I hit it in the corner and tap it with the hammer until we get released. In this case, we have Loki. Okay, now you want to remove the 12 millimeter down here in the caliper. After you remove the 12mm, you're gonna lift it up and slice it out. It won't come off. Now, we wanna use our hanger. We wanna hand the caliper through the chuck. So like this, the brake line don't get tension and don't go bad. Now, after you release the caliper and remove it, you wanna remove this 17mm. It's gonna be holding the bracket for the caliper. I wanna remove it with my gun, but you guys can remove it by hand. I'm gonna be using a swivel with 17 with my gun, but you guys can use it by hand, like I told you, with a big ratchet. Move one. Move the other one. After you got it loose, you just turn it. This is the bracket for the caliper. We're gonna replace with a brand new brake pads, brand new trims. We're gonna change the rotor now. In this case, the rotor don't wanna come out because it got rusty around the hub built in with the rotor. So the best way you can get it out is give it a really sharp tap here, like this. And that's how you remove the rotor when you get stuck there with the hole. Alright, when you're gonna go installing back the rotors, you wanna remove all the grease that the rotor has. Like you guys can see down here, the rotor comes with grease for manufacturing oil, for keeping it to get rusty. So we wanna remove all that oil. To remove that oil, you're gonna need brake cleaner. Some people give it one hand, I like to give it two hands always. Gonna clean it like that, with a clean rag. Make sure that you get all that oil. If you don't clean your rotor properly, you're gonna be having an accident in the street. When you don't clean your rotors, the brake pad is metal. It's gonna be touching with the caliper, with the rotor, the brake pad. When you don't got no oil, it's gonna make a good friction. But when you use it with oil, without cleaning it, it's just the brake pad is gonna be slicing in the rotor. Now we clean the other side. Now we want to start removing the brake pad for the caliper bracket. First one out. Now we have to hit the other one. The guy never replaced the brake pad in time. Like you guys can see, full of dust, but after you remove the brake pad, you want to clean the shims. For that, I use a file. un podcast play 266. And now we're gonna loop the other one. You removing all the S's. After you remove all the S's, you're gonna put the bracket back. You're gonna put 70 millimeters back. You're going to put the second one. You're gonna get it by hand the most that you can. And I'm coming right back, I wanna torque this. Okay, after you finish torquing the caliper bracket, you wanna remove the caliper from the handle. Now we're gonna start compressing the caliper. To compress the caliper, I like to use this tool. You can get something similar in the auto parts store. I like to put the old brake pad in the front. And after that, start compressing. Okay. After you do that, we're gonna grease the pins. Now we're gonna grease the pins. Same thing with the other one. Now I'm gonna put the brake pads on. Always make sure that you put the sensor where it belongs. Now we're gonna put grease on the brake pads. Same with the other side. To help with the noise. Now we want to put the number 12 back to hold the bracket with the caliper together. And now I'm gonna torque this, but bada bing bada boom, that's how you do front brake pads and roller and 2012 Honda Accord 4-cylinder.